Hello, beautiful people. Welcome to A Doctor's View. Today, I'm with a very special guest to discuss the movie Knives Out. I'm not yet going to introduce her, but I'll let her say a word or two.
Hello. So excited to be on.
It's a pleasure having you on.
Thank you.
Without further much ado, let's check first clip. Wow, this is one of the best actors in UK. He's British, right?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. I think I always get them confused. And
he played James Bond, right?
Yeah. It's true. Yeah. Very true. Very, very true. That's David.
Daniel Craig.
Wow. Okay, enough of my little knowledge of movies. What was he doing?
Okay, so in that clip, you can see he's smoking a cigar.
Okay.
So some people smoke cigarettes, some people smoke cigars, some people smoke e-cigarettes. But the common theme in all of them is the nicotine. So that's what you find.
What does that do to the body?
So nicotine is a stimulant and it works on something called the reward pathway. Okay. So it releases something called dopamine, which gives you a feeling of happiness.
Okay.
So that's why you see many people addicted to smoking, because of the nicotine. They want to continue that feeling of being happy.
Why do people keep increasing the amount they take? Because it seems to just keep getting worse and worse.
It does. So yeah. Many people start off with just the one cigarette.
Mm-hmm.
And you see people that smoke maybe 20. I've seen cases of people on 40 cigarettes a day. What the reason is something called tolerance.
Okay.
So they need more cigarettes to get the nicotine, to get that feeling, so that one cigarette no longer does the job. They're going to have to take more just to
more.
Get that feeling of that excitement, of that happiness.
Is there nicotine also in e-cigarettes that we see?
Is nicotine.
Okay.
But there's no tobacco in the e-cigarette.
Okay.
So it doesn't produce tar or carbon monoxide. There's not a lot of evidence on e-cigarettes at the moment, so I don't want to say too much.
Mm-hmm.
But there are, you know, a few other side effects. But if you're worried, speak to your doctor.
And what does smoking cause to the body?
So smoking can cause many cancers, throat cancer, mouth cancer, lung cancer.
Mm-hmm.
So it's many cancers. Nicotine as well can cause increase in heart rate.
Okay.
And increase in blood pressure, which is harmful to the body as well.
So how do we manage such a thing? How can somebody, stop his addiction to it?
So, you know, the phrase cold turkey doesn't tend to really work because the withdrawal symptoms are very bad.
Okay.
So what you see with people, it's something called nicotine replacement therapy.
Okay.
And that's in like the forms of like gum, lozenges,
mm-hmm.
inhalation. So the aim is that, you know, they take nicotine. So they will start with a high dose of like a chewing gum, maybe 21 milligrams. And you want to reduce them to 7 to 14 first, maybe then 7, to the point where they don't need any nicotine anymore.
Okay, and can you also tell us how to manage it? What drugs will we use?
So there's two drugs that you see used. The first one is something called varenicline.
Okay.
And the other one is bupropion.
And I don't think it's something that I can just get over the counter.
No. For those, you definitely need a prescription and you need to see your doctor.
Wow. That's quite informative. Okay. Have you actually received an IV medication before?
So I haven't received an IV, but I've had, you know, just the injection.
Okay,
into...
like the flu jabs.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I've received an IV and it's not one of the best things.
Really? Does it hurt?
No, it doesn't, funny enough.
Oh, wow.
Oh, there's a look of concern. Oh, don't tell me. Okay, now that's bad news.
Very bad.
She seemed to have switched the medication. I did catch a glimpse of morphine and ketorolac, right?
Yeah, that's what I saw as well.
Can you tell me what drugs they are and what they are used for?
Okay, so morphine is what you call an opioid.
Okay.
And that's mainly used in pain management. You see it in hospital more than you see it, you know, out in the community pharmacy. And ketorolac is what you call an NSAID. So that's similar to ibuprofen.
Okay.
Yeah.
Morphine. She seemed to have overdosed the old guy with it. What can that cause?
So an overdose in morphine is not good at all.
Okay.
It can cause respiratory depression.
Okay.
So that means that he can stop breathing.
Wow.
So that is not great.
That does not sound. And funny enough, I've been hearing this opioid epidemic in America and to a lesser degree here in the UK. Can you tell me what brought about that?
Yeah, so the opioid epidemic, it kind of started with the release of a drug called OxyContin by a pharmaceutical company in America. So they branded it as, you know, this great new drug that helps pain, no side effects, it's just amazing. So a lot of doctors began to overprescribe it. And what you see with opioid addiction is that many people who are addicted, when we speak about opioid addiction, you know, there's the drugs like the heroin, cocaine, methamphetamine, things like that. So they would have started off on a prescription, and because they can no longer get the prescription,
they go to
the street to get that, to get their kick, basically.
Wow. You did say something about tolerance when we're talking about nicotine. Does this also apply here in opioid?
It does. Opioid is a stimulant that acts on the reward pathway, so it gives that feeling of euphoria. And with tolerance, like you just said, you know, the first dose that you take is no longer enough. You need more of a higher dose to get that initial effect.
That same feel.
Exactly.
And I've also been hearing of recent in most music videos, lean. Are the artists trying to lose weight or something?
No, they're not trying to lose weight. Who knows these days?
Yeah, it could be.
But lean is basically, it's a mixture of a cough medicine. Some mixtures have codeine and promethazine. And what they do is they put like a soda and some sweets to give it that purple color. And, you know, they have it in these plastic cups.
Okay.
So, you know, codeine is an opioid as well. So they can become addicted to that. I know Justin Bieber recently spoke about his addiction.
Okay.
Drake has a song where he refers to Robitussin, which is one of the cough medicines that they use in lean. So you hear about it a lot in popular culture, which is not good, but you know.
That's the life we live now.
Yeah.
And so how do we manage such an addiction?
So again, similar to nicotine, just going cold turkey and just stopping the opioid, it tends to come with these effects, the withdrawal symptoms that are really, really bad. You see it like sweating and insomnia. Many people can't cope. So you tend to manage it with another opioid called methadone.
Okay.
So methadone is an opioid, but it doesn't produce that feeling of euphoria.
Okay.
So people don't tend to get too addicted to it, but it still kind of just keeps them okay.
Okay. And in the scenario where a person ODs, that's overdoses, is there an emergency medication for such?
Yeah, so there is, and it's called naloxone. So in the case of like respiratory depression, if a patient is administered naloxone, they tend to be able to breathe again with the help of, you know, maybe oxygen as well.
Wow, thanks a lot. I think we can safely sail on to our next clip then.
Yeah.
Okay. That's bad, man. She just okay, it's obvious she just vomited.
Yeah,
that one anybody can see that. But can you briefly tell us what causes vomiting?
So vomiting can have different causes. So it's a symptom. It could be caused by food poisoning, motion sickness, pregnancy, chemotherapy, migraines, anxiety, and also a lot of alcohol.
That's so true. So what do we do in such a scenario? How can we manage it?
So initially, you know, we tell the patient to drink plenty of water, to rest, to only have small plain meals, and rehydrate as well with like oral rehydration salt. And there are some medications available as well to treat vomiting.
Okay, so can you give us some of the names of such meds?
Yep, so there's one called promethazine, hyoscine, metoclopramide, and they all work on different parts of the body.
So basically, we definitely need to know what's causing the vomiting to even think of initiating treatment.
Exactly. So with vomiting, you don't want to just put a plaster on it. You want to do some digging and find out what's causing it, because if you find out what's causing it, then you know you can be able to stop the vomiting.
Wow, thank you so much, my mysterious guest.
thank you for having me.
Just before she introduces herself, please like, share, subscribe, and yeah, let me leave a trivial question for today. Can you name one of the medications for the management of nicotine? Yeah, one of the long ones she was really struggling to pronounce. Down in the comment section below, and yeah, can you please introduce yourself?
Hello, I'm so excited to be on today.
Yay.
My name is Ebon. I'm a pharmacist. I work in a community pharmacy in Northwest London. So I'm very passionate about health and lifestyle. I speak a lot about vitamins, supplements, lifestyle factors. I write for a magazine, and I lead a platform called Health in the City, which basically promotes being healthy in London City.
Hi, thank you so much for joining us. My name is Dr. Abe, and I'll catch you in our next episode.